Bob, a fun one in Atlanta tonight. This is a team that has given the Nets some fits, and Steve Nash, prior to the game, recognized that it's not a great matchup for Brooklyn. Their size, their scoring ability, their length, and it came down to the wire. Forced overtime, Hawks continued to attack the rim, but the Nets' big three, again, too much for Atlanta to handle. This is going to be an issue for a lot of teams around the NBA. Can you go out and just outscore the Nets? That's what most teams are going to have to face, that question, whether or not you can actually pull it off against the kind of talent that Brooklyn brings.
What has been nice to see additionally in these wins for the Nets is when it matters in closing time, they're also getting just enough stops to be able to pull out these victories. And for as much as we can applaud what we see on the offensive end, which there is a lot to gush about, not just in terms of the big three, but also so many of the complementary players, whether it's Joe Harris, Jeff Green, additional guys making important timely plays, but defensively they seem to be coming together more in terms of their communication, their rotations, and an understanding in the effort and the willingness to make those second effort plays. And I think overall too, when you look at Atlanta, just the tough matchup with the size, the length, athleticism, they've got playmakers, they've got shooters, they've got a little bit of everything on that side of the ball. The Nets did a good job rebounding, and I think that's been one of their Achilles heels throughout this season, is giving up second chance opportunities. Atlanta comes in second rebounding team in the league, third in terms of offensive rebounds and second chance points, and the Nets did a really nice job throughout the course of the game taking care of the basketball. Some of the areas that are of concern, they're starting to improve on.
No doubt. We're going to keep an eye on minutes throughout the season and how Steve Nash monitors that with the big three. We were curious if anybody would step forward on the bench. At halftime, the bench had done very little. Second half, fourth quarter in particular, Jeff Green, Bruce Brown, both of them made impactful plays that did play a role in the fact that the Nets won this game. Not just the big three, but Brown and Green playing a large role.
And the plays that jump out are the highlight dunks by Jeff Green, but how about a big timely three-pointer that he knocks down the stretch to help give a little bit of breathing room. Bruce Brown on the offensive end, despite the fact that so much of the reason he's on the floor comes with his defensive prowess and presence, he's just very comfortable finding places on the floor to give an availability to pass for his teammates, and he's knocking down those shots around the rim, the 10-15 footers that you want to see out of him. So for that reason, really important. Also, I think in this game, this was the first time we really saw James Harden be aggressive early on and throughout. And there was a nice balance between Harden, Irving, and Durant, and when they were looking to shoot, when they were sharing the basketball. And you saw that trickle into the entire roster in the lineup.
So the Nets get some revenge here against the Hawks. Atlanta won the last meeting between these two teams, and then they'll face a similar situation. Oklahoma City is coming up on the schedule. Last time they played, it was the Thunder that surprised the Nets with a win here in Brooklyn.